Today on Sam's Game Room, the slowest car I've ever driven.
Jammin'.
This is the 2001 Ford Ranger XLT. It's the short cab, short bed, rear-wheel drive, 2.3-liter Duratec i4 automatic. The only positive thing about that last sentence was the rear-wheel drive part, but even that's unexciting when you actually drive the thing. This car is slow. Really slow. As in, it takes full throttle to take off from a stoplight at decent speed if the AC is on slow. But it does sound fast.
That was 25.
That's because, in the Sam's Game Room car review tradition, it has an exhaust leak. While the battery does say XLT, you'd be hard-pressed to tell it was without it. It seems the only options this car has are chrome bumpers and grille, and yes, the bumper is real metal, an automatic transmission, and a CD player. This is pretty basic. There aren't even inner fenders on the rear wheels. That's the parking brake cable. Right there. Yep. Ford quality. Speaking of Ford quality, check out the interior. It looks like it was designed by Fisher-Price during their goth period. This panel here, it's not broken. It just looks like it. Okay, handling. Not okay. It floats in the worst possible way. This car wanders at speed, and the steering is wallowy. The suspension makes it seem like a carnival ride the way it bounces around. In fact, one time while driving I-75 near Dayton, a stretch of road that seems to have been under construction since its conception, a particularly bad bump launched me into another lane, which was thankfully uninhabited. Don't try to corner hard one of these, it feels like it's going to tip over any second. There is one time when this truck's handling really shines, though, and that's the winter. All you Ken Block wannabes with your front-wheel drive, one-wheel peel Honda Civics with no mufflers, listen up. Get a rear-wheel drive Ranger. Any model, any configuration, it doesn't matter. And just wait for some snow. You can safely live out your drift fantasies at 20 miles an hour on any road that's been poorly plowed. Just don't get carried away and try to hold too much speed, or you'll slide into a ditch faster than a Mustang owner just pulled out of a Cars and Coffee next to a red Corvette. The acceleration of the Ranger is excruciating. Not for the passengers, but for the vehicle itself. This truck is an ASPCA commercial on wheels. Hey, look, I'm sorry, Ranger. I should have been generous on the gas, I'll admit it. Okay, next time we'll ease up on the speed, I promise. Just don't... Don't look at me like that, okay? 0-60 comes eventually. Just under 16 seconds in normal driving. But for this clip, we turned the overdrive and AC off to give it the best possible chance and got there in a little over 13 seconds. Top speed is supposedly limited to 90, but I've heard stories of people taking them faster. Personally, I wouldn't dare try this. This thing is scary enough on interstate at 75, I can't imagine what it would be like at 100. Short cab, how useful is it? Well, the split bench can hold 3 uncomfortably, or 5 if you get really creative, though that's a story for after the statute of limitations passes. The center seatbelt is a throwback to the 1970s, you get a tad of space back here, everything creaks, and you'll feel like you're sitting on instead of inside the truck. Cargo space in the short bed should be adequate, though a cover is really needed for it to be useful, especially in rain or snow. It was at this point that I planned to triumphantly show that my Passat has more space, before realizing that the vertical capacity of the Ranger is limited only by the laws of physics and the height of the bar at the McDonald's drive-thru. And you know, speaking of McDonald's, this truck's really a lot like a McDonald's double cheeseburger when you think about it. I mean, it isn't that great, but if we're being honest, it's good in its own unique ways every now and then. And it'll likely kill you if you use it too often.